هذا الكويتمنت. What happened?
Caught on one of the branches on the way down.
Can you walk? Stitches.
Didn't tie your parachutes very well. You left the blood trail for half a kilometer. Follow me. I live not far from here. Dick, come. Ignatz! Ignatz!
Hot soup. Come. Come in.
I take it you're heading for Prague.
How far is it?
30 kilometers. I have a special delivery permit for my truck. I could take you.
Thank you.
You rest here tonight. I will take you in the morning. Enjoy your soup.
Please, sit.
Drop the gun! Drop it! Drop the gun!
Him. We'll take that truck. Come on. They made their choice, Jan. Sometimes you have to pick a side. Would you prefer it with us?
Left. Pull over here.
Looking for Oleg Novak?
Novakovi no longer live here.
Who is he?
Just somebody looking for directions. I am sorry, but that's all I know.
Please. Can you help us?
There is a veterinarian in the next row of shops up the street. I hear he is a good man. One that may help.
Thank you.
He normally only barks at Germans.
Mm-hmm. Germans. And anyone giving him a rectal examination.
Thank you, Dr. Edward. Come along. Benes?
Look after him, Mrs. Lukashova.
Normally, for a dog bite, you go to a hospital, not a vet.
Did you know Oleg Novak?
Yes.
And what if we were to say that Oleg Novak was our contact here in Prague?
Then I would have to wonder if you are ill-informed Czech patriots or Gestapo spies trying to infiltrate what remains of the resistance. I don't detect a German accent. The decoding papers in your bag, they don't have a German font. And given that this wound has more tree bark than dog bite, I would have to guess that you were parachuted back into Czechoslovakia with information that was somewhat out of date.
You're a clever man. They've also told you you're a good man.
How long have you been away?
It's been a while.
Awards are given to people. Inform an anti-Nazi activity. Heydrich has all but crushed the resistance. He has executed thousands. I can put you in contact with the Miller. Maybe he can help you. You can stay here tonight. I'll contact the Miller in the morning.
My friend here says that you are a clever man. I agree. Don't do anything that would change our opinion.
Go easy on the foot. You'll be dancing the tango within a week.
Bratislav. The Miller.
Edward told me you were looking for Oleg Novak.
Yes.
Would you like to take a drive with me? Don't move.
Please sit.
You were looking for Oldrich Novak.
Who gave you this contact?
London.
And you tell us this because?
You're not giving us much choice. And this doesn't look like Gestapo headquarters.
You? Where are you from? Your accent, Bohemia?
No. Dolnoj Belomovice. Moravia.
So you must know the railway station at Vladislav.
Yes.
What's so special about it?
I presume you're talking about the large bed of colored roses that, when seen from above, is in the shape of our national flag. Is it still there?
Since the Germans have still not looked at it from above. I am Vanek. Ladislav Vanek. This is Uncle Heisky. We're the head of the Indra organization, Czech Resistance.
I'm Jan Kubisch.
I'm Josef Gabčík from Slovakia.
You must not be surprised by our lack of trust. The Gestapo have been very successful in infiltrating our network. Ulrich Novak. He was taken away several months ago.
Why wasn't London informed?
We lost contact with the Czech government in exile in London some months ago. We need replacement crystals for the transmitter. We've been waiting for them to send someone to re-establish contact. Is that you?
There were other men on the plane. They were dropped elsewhere. It's possible they have orders to re-establish contact with London, but that is not our mission.
What is your mission?
Operation Anthropoid.
Anthropoid?
What is Anthropoid?
We are here to assassinate SS Obergruppenführer Reinhard Heydrich.
Are you completely mad?
We have our orders.
But this is madness.
We have our orders, comrade.
Heydrich? Why stop with Heydrich? Why not have a go at Hitler as well? He's only 300 kilometers down the road in a small village called Berlin.
So we inform London that you are refusing to cooperate with our mission.
How dare you question us? How dare you question us? You know what we have sacrificed for
sacrificed.
The cause here?
But you have
you know
sacrificed
what we have sacrificed
for the Czechoslovakia sacrifice!
You have no idea what the Czechoslovakia sacrifice! You kill Heydrich. And Hitler will tear Prague apart. I take it you have family in Czechoslovakia. Father, mother. You kill Heydrich, then you can consider them and everyone that ever knew you dead.
All Czech patriots should be ready to die for their country. That includes my family.
Well, I'm not. I want to carry on fighting. We don't have that many left that are willing to do that. We are what's left of the Czech resistance. I suggest a lesser rank should be assassinated, perhaps a few of them.
Heydrich is the head of the secret police. Only Hitler and Himmler are above him in the Nazi hierarchy.
Exactly my point. You really think you'll ever get close enough to assassinate Heydrich?
Our orders have come direct from the Czech government in London.
So this is about the Czech government in London trying to impress the Allies? It was the Allies that gave us to the Germans in the first place.
Munich was a betrayal. But it is also now history. I think what the Czech government in London is asking is this. Is Czechoslovakia still ready and willing to resist Nazi Germany? Josef Kapcsik and Jan Kubiš.
You are both most welcome here. And please call me Auntie Moravec. Aťa? Aťa? Aťa is my son. He's studying to be a violinist. Aťa, this is Josef and this is Jan.
Pleased to meet you both. So, try not to go outside. But if you do, never walk together. If you're stopped, you need an excuse for why you're not at work. We'll try to get you medical certificates as soon as possible. Always use our code. 3 knocks, then a single knock. In the meantime, lay low, and I will use Aťa to make contact. Good luck.
Come on through, please.
Josef. You're just way off the roof.
There is a fire escape to the left. To the right, it continues to the building next door.
It's good enough.
I'm sure you both would like a glass of Becherovka.
Thank you.
It's okay.
Mrs. Moravec?
There's so much people at the market. But I couldn't find the bread that you like.
Come.
What is it? It's okay, Maria. This is Josef and this is Jan. They will be staying with us while they are looking for work.
Pleased to meet you.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Josef and Jan are not registered with the police as being residents here. So remember, please keep it strictly to yourself.
I'll put the shopping in the kitchen. Welcome.
Mrs. Kovarnikova's daughter. I pay her for helping out. Dinner will be at 6.
Please sit. Aťa, dinner is ready.
And finally, the fiddler is silent.
He's a violinist, Alois. A violinist.
You two boys looking for work then?
Yes.
We are always looking for a man to clean the cinders out of the locomotives.
Thank you, Mr. Moravec. We'll keep that in mind.
So, what do you do when you aren't helping out here? You don't have a boyfriend?
How's life in occupied Prague, Marie?
I guess not being registered with the police as residents has something to do with this question. I hate Germans.
And tell me, do you have a friend as lovely as you that that you can trust?
Why?
It would be less conspicuous if Jan and I were not seen out alone. Young love flourishes under German occupation, that sort of thing.
But you're not that young.
Knowing that you are trustworthy is one thing, Marie. But doing this could get you shot. Perhaps you should think about
my friend Lenka. She sometimes carries messages for Uncle Heisky. we are going to a New Year's Eve dance tomorrow night. Would you like to go?
Look at them. It's like some old ritual that's lost its joy.
Maybe there's hope in the pretense. Looks like you landed on your feet with Lenka.
Hello? Lenka, this is Jan and Josef. You know, it's not very polite.
Please sit down. You are the most beautiful women in the room. Congratulations. But you fail to understand this is... This is not a night off for us. This is not some game.
Yes. Maybe you're overreacting.
Jan, take a look around. We appreciate the effort, but the point was not to attract attention. We needed you as plain as possible. Do you understand?
You know, for most girls, a little lipstick is the only way to forget what's happening here. Even if it's just for a few hours.
Yes. Your lipstick gets you noticed, and that gets us noticed, and us being noticed gets us all shot. This little scene needs an ending. It's not my face. It's not my face.
I'm not a whore.
I think that went well.
To stand Mark II machine gun, 100 rounds, and model 73 anti-tank grenades with fancy fuses. That's everything we could retrieve from the drop canister. Uncle says he has made some progress with the information you asked for. There's a meeting at Cafe Moravia on Vodichkova Street, Tuesday, 2:00.
I just wanted to apologize about the other night. You were completely right to do what you did. Maria didn't fully inform me about the situation. She's very young. She still has romantic ideas about the war.
And you?
War is not romantic. We cross here.
After our last date, I thought you might both show any potato sacks.
I don't know what I'm doing.
You're doing fine.
Can you sit here, order a drink? Your mom.
Josef.
Yeah.
Oh, Bocca.
Patrick.
see you are no strangers to one another, but we don't have much time.
We all trained special operations together. Baltic here was living on the same drop.
Yeah, drop 10 minutes later on 30 miles off course.
Thanks to Balchik and his group Silver A, we have finally re-established communications with London.
I've orders to send and receive any communications between you and London. You have your own decoder book, right?
Yes. Second Lieutenant Opalkai and Warrant Officer Churda have completed operation out distance, so both are now available to assist you. Second Lieutenant Opalkai is the senior officer here.
Yeah, this is true, but your mission objective supersedes my rank.
We had word from London.
Anthropoid, utmost priority. We assist with everything possible. So, this is your show, Bradtree.
So, we know that Heydrich returns to his family every day at Panensky Brezhany. But both his chateau and the castle are both heavily guarded. They are not feasible targets. And once a month, he also travels to Berlin by train. And we can predict this because his personal carriages are prepared several days in advance. But again, the station and the train are both heavily guarded.
What about derailing the train outside of Prague?
We can derail the train, but that is no guarantee that Heydrich is killed.
I have made contact with an ex-pupil of mine who works as a repairman inside the castle. He's willing to help, but he only knows when Heydrich arrives in the morning and when he leaves.
What good is that?
Can build a picture of his routine. Sometimes he travels with an armed escort, and sometimes he does not. Perhaps there is a pattern in this. There is a safe house near the castle. The repairman could drop off the timetable every day before work. Linka or Marie could collect it.
Good. And Jan and I will follow the route from the chateau to the castle.
Gentlemen, this operation will involve almost everyone we have left in the resistance. So many have been captured by the Gestapo. If you are arrested, you will face some harsh facts. There will be no escape. You will be tortured until you reveal everything you know. And then you will be executed. You must protect your fellow comrades by shutting down any links you have to them. Operation Outdistance has resupplied us with these. Carry the cyanide capsules at all times.
We have to end our meeting. Use the window.
Lassen Sie ihn.
Claire.
Looks like there's a whole garrison there.
That's our man. 5 minutes after 9.
He's riding solo today. Wait.
Arm desk on. 30 seconds behind.
30 seconds. 30 seconds. 30 seconds. If we can use a rope or a steel cable to stop the Mercedes, in 30 seconds. In 30 seconds would be all we need.
Even if a rope can't stop the car, we still need more than 30 seconds to escape from here. And we'd have to face the armed guard here in the open. It would not be my first choice.
And if it's our only choice. The point of the mission is to succeed, yes?
I'm more worried that we haven't planned what to do if we are successful.
What happens afterwards is not important. Let's follow the route to the castle.
Well,
arrived 9:15, left 5:15, and with an armed escort.
Armed escort? There's only one person in Prague that travels with an armed escort. Are you going to assassinate Heydrich?
What? Heydrich is the target?
For your own safety. It's best that you don't ask too many questions.
It's a bit too late for that, no?
Well, you agree to help the resistance. Who the target is should not concern you.
We are about to help you assassinate Reinhard Heydrich. Of course, it concerns us.
Okay, everyone just relax. Maybe it was a mistake not to inform you of the danger.
Murder Heydrich?
No, no. Assassinate Heydrich. Murder implies he has a life worth living.
So you think we are just two little girls who are here to follow the important parachutists around?
Oh, thank you.
We've been resisting here from the beginning in our own way. I personally don't have any reservation to killing a Nazi pig. But don't treat us like what you are about to do doesn't affect us. It does, and it will. And you should keep your weapon clean because it's filthy.
Maria, where are all my pots and pans?
This exit here is this. You see? It's the slowest part of the route. Anywhere else is impossible. So we do it here. Agreed?
Yes. Perhaps not perfect, but it's the best option.
11:17 to 4:41 without.
Are you really going to go through with this?
We have orders.
So you kill Heydrich. But then? You think Darren more like him? They come and the killing continues even worse than it did before. When does it stop?
I wish I had an answer for you. You think any of this makes sense to me?
Then walk away now.
And go there, Maria. You think we can escape from what is happening here? Pretend this madness is not real?
So some days I'm not even sure it is real. Heydrich chokes the people of this city with a blanket of fear. People are shot for what? Their race, their religion, their cigarettes? You hear the stories about Poland.
Shh, Maria, it's okay.
Just tell me we are doing the right thing.
My turn to apologize to you about the other morning. You have a right to be angry. We should have told you what was at risk, given you the choice to walk away.
My father was a captain in the army. Wanted sons. Got three daughters. He and many others were arrested in 1939 when Germany took control over Czechoslovakia. And when Heydrich took over here last September, his first order was to execute all the prisoners. My father was among 5,000 shot in the first week by Heydrich. For me, there's no walking away. Heydrich is worth the risk.
Have you checked the route? I think we know how to do it.
We'll arrange a meeting at the cafe the day after tomorrow, 3 p.m.
Our original contact, Ulrich Novak. Who was his direct handler?
Vladislav Vaniek.
He is the one who is most opposed to what we have to do. All I'm asking is, what is he so afraid of?
Jan?
Sorry. Is here, corner of Kirschmayrova and Malholoshevich Street. Here.
His car would have to really slow down to take that corner.
Yes, he slows to about 10 miles per hour.
We've averaged out his morning arrival times and can expect him at approximately 9:30 a.m.
And the weapons?
At that range, the Sten gun should hit everything within the car.
Mm-hmm. And the armed escort?
We have found no pattern. Some days yes, some days no.
If there is an armed escort, we stand down and await the next day.
You know I have been against this action from the start.
Yes, that's been clear.
I cannot give the go-ahead without asking London to reconsider.
Ladislav, this is a military operation. It's not your order to...
Without the resistance, this mission doesn't exist.
What the fuck? I am with Ladislav. We shall get London to rethink our position here in Prague.
We have our orders, Jordan. Nothing has changed.
It's easy for London to give orders. It's our lives online.
Just wait for a confirmation. We waited 4 months. 4 months. London needs action.
Then a few more days won't make a difference. Valchik, how long before we can get to the transmitter?
We can get to the transmitter the day after tomorrow. Then a couple of days for London to transmit back the answer.
I know this is your party, but we have a little announcement to make. I have asked Maria to marry me, and she has said yes.
Congratulations. Congratulations. Thank you. Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you. Why are we here? I know. Who's to say it won't happen? London calls it off.
You're lying to yourself, my friend. Because it is easier.
I have to believe there's a way through this. That there's a normal life waiting for us. The way things used to be. Maria makes me feel that there's hope. I love her. I do. I love her. Transfer the 73 into a water canteen for better mobility. Read for impaired detonation.
Don't drop them, eh?
That was the empty one.
No, not funny, man. Not funny.
Interpoise. Proceed. Stop. Utmost importance.
Nothing about getting us out afterwards.
There's a problem. One of our contacts inside the castle has seen correspondence ordering Heydrich back to Berlin. And there have been conversations in the household about a new posting to Paris. It means that once he goes to Berlin, he may not be back.
When does he leave?
Day after tomorrow.
Then we have no choice. We do it tomorrow. We do it tomorrow.
What? What is it?
Ladislav has received a new transmission from London.
And?
They agreed with my request to stand down the mission. We believe we see the situation clearly. Therefore, given the situation, any actions against officials of the German Reich do not come into consideration. Let the Indra Group know.
No. Ladislav, I've just decoded a message from London. Proceed, utmost importance.
But this clearly states you must stand down.
You are deluded. This is for Yindra. So how can we recognize this?
Then at least wait for us to clarify it. It may have superseded your order.
We have no time. After tomorrow, Heydrich will be gone.
I agree with Josef. I don't think this is a direct command. I believe its purpose is to calm the nerves in Yindra.
I know you all doubt me.
No, Ladislav.
Please stop. Suspect me of collaboration. I know you've had me followed. I understand you don't trust me, but if I was an informer for the Gestapo, you think you would still be here, do you?
And you tell me, Ladislav. What are you afraid of?
I fear Czechoslovakia will be wiped from the map. You ask me if I'm afraid? Yes, I'm afraid.
Yeah, Uncle. We do it tomorrow. As planned.
I've shot a man in the field. Never killed one up close.
Give me the gun. Give me the gun.
I don't want to die tomorrow.
Give me the gun. Leave. Now. Thank you, Mr. Martin. Thank you. Breathe. 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 Breathe, young. Good. As we were trained. As we were trained.
Concentrate on the detail.
Good. Good.
Czechoslovakia is not afraid. Huh?
I'll wait for you up the street.
Uncle said we weren't needed for a while. Is it today? Promise me.
Plenty of time. 8:25. Where's Chota?
Never mind. Belchik, you take the street behind me. We have some sun. So take this. If he approaches without an armed escort, then use it to signal.
And if he does?
Then... then light a cigarette. When the car slows to take the corner, I will step out and open fire with the stand gun. This will signal the attack. Jan, you stand behind the attack point so you can throw grenades at the armed escort if there is one. Opalka, you try a slow walk across here. As he approaches, maybe you can slow him down before he takes the corner. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Good luck.
Julia!
Who are you, Surda?
I didn't think that you were really going to do it. It's all over the radio.
You shot him? The radio said there are 20,000 SS troops have been drafted in to look for us. I need to get my family out of Prague. No one is going anywhere, Surda. You try and run now, they will pick you up before you reach the city limits. You go home to your family, you stay calm, you shut them up. You think you could do that?
Yeah.
Huh? We failed, Chanda.
What? No.
We failed.
Then I'm sorry.
Wird gemeinsam mit seiner gesamten Familie erschossen. Karel Frank has temporarily taken Heydrich's place and has proclaimed a state of emergency and a curfew. A reward of 10 million crowns will be given for any information that leads to the arrest of the criminals. Anyone caught aiding the criminals will be shot, along with his entire family.
What went wrong out there?
We didn't even kill him.
Wounded.
How bad?
It's hard to say. The SS still have the hospital surrounded, so presumably he is still alive. It seems like the Germans have more men and guns up there than on the Eastern Front. They've taken several thousand hostages.
So what do we do now?
Nothing. He's leaving. We're entering Prague. You're searching door to door. We have no safe houses left.
So where do we go?
I've asked Father Vladimir Petrek.
He has agreed to hide all the parachutists that are still here in Prague until we can return you to London. Wait here a few hours. I will find a safe route to the cathedral.
I'm sorry. This is my bad, I'm sorry.
Father Petrek will meet you in there. I've sent food with Atya. Go, go.
Thank you.
I regret nothing. You're the bravest man I've ever met.
Father Petrek, welcome. Please come with me. This is our hidden crypt. You will be safe there.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, this is Schwartz, Bublik, and Ruby. They're from the airdrop this spring.
Boredom may be the biggest enemy we have here. I'm suggesting 3 men on guard duty on the nave balcony at all times. We rotate every 6 hours. These 3 take first watch. Wasn't the outcome we all hoped for.
None more than us.
Reinhard Heydrich has died in hospital. A direct result of the injuries sustained in the attack. Yesterday, the Germans went to a village of Lidice and shot every man over the age of 16. The women and children have been taken to camps, and the buildings were razed to the ground. There has been talk that the village aided you somehow.
I've never even been to Lidice.
These are dangerous times. May our gossip wipes a whole village from the face of the earth. Today, Karl Frank issued an amnesty broadcast. A full pardon for any person and their family in exchange for any information about the assassins, even if they did not come forward before. But there is a deadline of 5 days. After that, they plan to execute 30,000 Czechs.
This must stop.
What do you propose?
Me and Yosef will go to a park. Place placards around our neck saying that we killed Hydrick. And commit suicide.
Leon!
Stupid talk. This is stupid talk! As a soldier, it is your duty to stay alive and continue fighting. Do you understand that, Warrant Officer Kubish?
The responsibility has not rested here. We know who is responsible. They will have to answer, eventually. And they will. If I didn't believe that, I would not be here now.
Thank you, Father.
Have you seen Maria? Is she well?
Beyond this brickwork and masonry, there is a large man's sewer that empties into the river.
How do you know?
I found some plans in Father Petre's office. If we can chisel through this, we have a means of escape.
Escape to where?
Well, until the British send plans for our rescue, we are stuck here. Should it be discovered, there is no way out. I would like us at least to have this option. We would then take our chances in the streets. Two men should be working here at all times.
What's her name?
Lenka.
Earlier, what Jan said. About taking your own lives. Was he serious?
Maybe.
Cowards die many times before their deaths. The valiant never tastes death but once. Shakespeare.
You say you know the man who assassinated Reichsprotector Reinhard Heydrich, but you didn't take part in it. You say you don't know where they are, but you know the family who sheltered them. walked in here on your own accord to give up this statement. You say you are a true patriot, and the reason for doing that is because you want to protect your family and for the killing of innocent Czechs to stop. And you say your name is Karol Cholla.
Wo ist der Dolmetscher?
Galupski!
Alle an der Wand!
Bring die Frau her. Wo sind die Fallschirmspringer?
Where are the parachutists?
I know nothing. You must be confusing us, Mr. Moravec.
Hebt sie auf.
Jawohl.
Wo sind die Fallschirmspringer?
Where are the parachutists?
Los, alles nochmal durchsuchen. Überall, los!
Please. Let me clean myself up before I leave.
Go on, then.
My son is a violinist. Tell them he knows nothing of this. Please.
Wo ist die Frau?
In der Toilette.
Scheiße! 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 Scheiße!
Has talked to Father Petrek. Apparently, our presence here is endangering the church. He wants us to leave. But Petrek has talked to Heisky, and there is a plan to get us all out.
When?
Two in the coffins, two under the dummy floor, and the other three disguised as Paul Burris. That's the seven. How soon can you be ready?
You like to play the violin? Maybe you would like to see your mother again. Yes, he managed to save her.
No, no.
He saved her head. Where are the assassins? Where are the assassins? Where are they hiding? Where are they hiding?
Please, Bob.
Where are the assassins? Where are they hiding?
Don't.
Where are they?
They're in the charge. In the Sulan Madonius charge.
The Germans are surrounding the church. We have to warn the others.
No, there is no time. Take up defensive positions. We hold them from here. Bublik, take the upper gallery.
man.
We have to help them. We must not give ourselves away, Joseph.
You're the judge.
Look, the stairwell.
That's our only way out.
It's also the only way up.
I don't want to die today.
Let's use the trench.
Look. Listen, listen.
Concentrate on the detail. That's it.
I'm sorry, Yelta.
Okay? Listen, listen.
We're all here with you. In Czechoslovakia, is here with us.
Stop!
Thank you.
last one.
This is Jan Kubiš. That's Adolf Opálka. And him, I don't know, but it's not Josef Gabčík or Valčík.
Tschechen rein. Mach, dass er mit ihnen redet. Er soll sie überzeugen, damit sie endlich aufgeben. Unsere Geduld ist gleich am Ende.
You should get your friends to surrender.
Josef, you should surrender now and save yourselves.
That's Schulter.
Do you hear me?
Schulter!
Schulter!
You will be treated humanely as prisoners of war.
We are Czechs! You will never surrender!
Feuer frei!
Yeah.
This is the last one for us.
Hier ist Eingang.
Ja, hier ist der Eingang. Hier.
Wer rollt hier den Teppich weg?
Marsch, Marsch! Jawohl! Wird gemacht!
Wir brauchen ein Sprengkommando.
Sprengkommando! Gleich!
Gut. Alle raus.